Gums. Gums are normally produced by plants in response to injury. Gums are polysaccharides of salts of sugars other than glucose. When we remember plant material, the two main sugars that we have are glucose and fructose. We're really looking at other material: arabinose, fucose, galactose, mannose, rhamnose, xylose. These can be 5 or 6 carbon sugars. They're carbohydrates, just like other sugars. However, they may not be normally digested. Remember, you've got microorganisms in your digestive system that are picking up these materials. They are providing enzymes. These are materials that don't come in a lot. Therefore, the enzymes may not be present or may not be stimulated. Gums are considered to be non-digestible, which means they pass through the digestive system. Normally, from the time you consume it until it is excreted, is going to be in the 24 to 48 hour period. They do not last for decades, like some people would tell you. There are several different kinds of gums that we're going to look at. The first one says it's an exudate gum. That means it is secreted on the outside. It is a response to what is going on around it. Knowing that they were secreted, people often tried to drain them from the stem. They might have done it too aggressively. As they did that, they often killed the plant from which it came. Nowadays, we know that we can get these out without being nearly as violent on the plant. These things are exudate gums. Gum arabic, which is from the plant Senegalia senegal, from sub-Saharan Africa, was one of the first ones that was ever used. They called it gum arabic because it was often taken up to ports in Arabia, where it was then distributed worldwide. It's just drained out of the stem. It is a quite important gum. The plant looks like this. This is coming out of the stem. It's not coming out of the seed. It is a legume type plant. When we look at the gum, it looks like that. You see these little hard crystals of material can then be brought back by processing. This is the back of M&Ms. It's using gum acacia, which is another name for gum arabica. And this helps provide the hard candy shell on the outside. We have gum tragacanth. It comes from astragalus-type plants. There are several different ones, mostly out of Asia Minor. There are many uses for it. Main uses that we've been able to find include leather working. They often use it for putting on the outside of leather to be able to hold it together. It also is used in producing cigars. It is the glue in cigars. It is bled from the plant. It is then collected and processed. Got a picture of a couple of Cuban cigars. This Cuban cigars, therefore, would be glued together with this particular material to keep them from unwrapping. Another material that is exuded. This is gum caryaea. It comes from Sterichia urens. It can be used as a laxative. It can be used in the food industry. One of the places that I've seen it advertised is as the glue that they use to hold on colostomy bags. It is found in a powdered form. You mix it up with water. It makes it tacky or sticky so that you can use it kind of a gum to hold things together. It is hypoallergenic. In here, it comes from this particular tree. They scratch the tree on the outside, and it will then produce the gum, and then the gum can be collected. We also have gum ghadi. Gum ghadi is indigenous to India and Nepal. It is used for the production of what we call calico. Calico is a type of fabric. The fabric is treated with the gum that gives it its unique appearance. The material is picked up from the outside where the tree has been injured. This is what the inflorescence of the tree looks like. And you can see it's a very small type inflorescence. It's a fairly prolific tree. And it is used for calico, which would be a certain type of staining on cloth. There is also extractive type gums. With the extractive type gums, we're doing a process by which we are extracting it from the plant. This goes back to carob. We talked about carob, which is used to replace cocoa powder. In this particular case, we're taking the locust bean and we're using the seed in order to extract the gum. The gum is actually removed from the seed. One of the byproducts of the carob industry is you get the seed, and out of the seed we get the carob gum. Carob gum can be used for many different things. This is what the pods look like. They are quite unique, and that's your tree. We also have what we call guar gum. Guar gum comes from a legume. It is a galactomannan, galactose and mannose together. This particular gum is used a lot in the paper industry. It's often used to bind things together to be able to make certain types of paper. The plant it comes out of looks like this. It is a legume, got the little bean-like pods in it. And the seed comes out like that. They extract the gum from the seed. And then they use the gum as a adhesive. Everything else up to this point came out of the plant the way it was. It's used as it was from the plant. We also have a semi-synthetic gum. This is carboxymethyl cellulose. We take purified cellulose. It's treated with a strong alkali. This causes the fibers to break down. It makes it more soluble. Then we use this material in detergents and in food, called carboxymethyl cellulose. Sometimes it's referred to as CMC or cellulose gum, among others. And this is what the purified material looks like. If you're treating cellulose with strong alkali, you can manufacture anything. We have a cake mix, and on the back of the cake mix, what's it say there? We got cellulose gum, which is the carboxymethyl cellulose. It's going to help hold things together. When we're looking at gums, gums are salts of sugars that are not basically glucose type materials. As we get those, they sometimes tend to be indigestible because we don't necessarily have the material to break them down.